Welcome back after the short break. Now we have the pleasure to present Zebra Robotics. I think it's good that we took the green and now going to a different category to actually explain that it's not only the green transition that is impact, you know, it's also the transition, our education system, the savings, and actually getting people educated that has a huge impact on society. Therefore, I'm pleasure to present Zebra Robotics by David Christensen, CEO and co-founder. But I think, David, just take it from here.
Well, thanks a lot for the introduction. And what I'll tell you about today is some of the positive impact that we are making at Zebra Robotics, of course, as you say, in particular about quality education. So I'll try to explain how our products are helping children from all around the world to get a better education so that we can prepare them for a fast-changing future. So, as you already said, my name is David Johan Christensen. I have a background as a robotics researcher for many years before becoming the co-founder and CEO of Zebra Robotics, which we founded back in 2015. So this is the 17 sustainability goals of the United Nations. And at Zebra Robotics, we are trying to make an impact on several of these goals. But our main focus is on this goal 4, which is called quality education. So I'll dive a little bit into that one. So it shouldn't be a surprise to anyone that this kind of quality education, it makes a huge difference for the children that will receive, you know, a good education. It enables them to have mobility in terms of economical and social growth. It can grow up, get good jobs, you know, escape from poverty and so forth. It can reduce inequality between genders, for example. Many girls are unfortunately not going to school today, and that's something that many people are trying to address. And also, you know, if you have a society with a good quality education, then you can create a society that is more tolerant, that is most peaceful, that is innovative, create economic growth, and that is just better for everybody to live in that kind of society. So what we have done in order to help the schools provide excellent teaching for the students is that we have created this Fable ecosystem. So it consists of different robotic modules that the students can put together. It consists of software that they can program the robot with and so forth. And then, you know, for example, some students, they might go about creating welfare technology with the Fable system. So maybe they have some old grandparents that is struggling a little bit in their everyday lives. Maybe they cannot pick something up from the floor if they drop it on the floor and so forth. And these students, then they go and try to address that problem, build a robot that can actually help their grandparents. And in that way, the students, they learn something about innovation. They learn something about, you know, making an impact for other people, creating value for other people. And that is extremely important skills on top of all the technical skills that they also learn in that process. So this is something that has a big influence later in life and also in you know, what they will go about doing in the lives. So the amazing thing about programming a robot for a kid is that every time you program it, you learn something new. Perhaps what you learned wasn't what you were expecting would happen. Maybe it didn't work at all, but that's also important to learn that something, you know, sometimes doesn't work. And with the robots, we have more than 8,000 robots out there. You know, millions of programs have been running on a robot. And every time students have learned something in that process. And so this is something that is making a real impact on these students' lives. So now what I want to do is I want to show you a little video from a school in the UK that is using our robots. And this little video is sort of explaining how they're using the system to provide better education for the students.
And David, if you mute the sound, I will also do the same, and then you can watch the video.
Thanks for reminding me.
We've been able to take things off the screen and make it concrete. And what we found with Fable is it's really, really engaging. It's especially in a boys' school, the one thing I think we were really missing was the physical programming. And I think we were looking for something that we could not just build once, but something that was modular and that we could put together to create lots of different activities.
Today we programmed Fable to go around an obstacle course, and along that we had to do loads of challenges. So for example, we had to program it to complete a maze.
The boys learned how to get the ball bearing round to the centre by creating different functions. So that was a really fantastic lesson, and the boys came out of it really understanding what a function was, how to create a function.
It's fun because instead of using textbooks and loads of writing, it's more of a way which you can kind of express yourself in teamwork, and you get to use some more technology.
We wanted them to understand that it was equally as good to get something wrong as it was to get something right.
I struggle with it, but when I get going, I think it's a lot more easier and fun to work with.
And then you start seeing their faces light up, and they got really hooked onto, well, I can do this, I figured out how to do something.
If you're thinking about getting Fable, I really would recommend it, because it's a good addition to your school, because you can actually see your products in real life instead of just on a computer.
Good. So so the types of teaching that you saw in this video, that is really taking place in many classrooms, thousands of classrooms around the world, using our robots. So this is one of our latest projects. So it's actually a chain of these really outstanding international schools. It's called GEM Education, and it's the world's largest operator of schools. For going from the kindergarten age to grade 12, and we are doing a project together with them. It's with a specific school in Dubai that has 2,800 students, and is now using Fable, or starting to use Fable. With they have around 140 robots or so, and they will provide, you know, really good education with the robots in subjects like computing, math, science, and also artificial intelligence. So we know from experience that this is going to make a big impact on you know, the students going through these kinds of activities, what kind of education they will choose in the future, what they will do with their life going further. Another area where we are making an impact outside of, you could say, STEM education is really on the impact of well-being of students. So It's very close to our heart that we want to help these kids back in school if they, for some reason, are not able to come to school. So unfortunately, millions of students are homebound because of health issues. It could be cancer, but it could also be anxiety or other things that are keeping them at home. And to be honest, many of them are not receiving a particular good education at the moment. They're a little bit left alone at home. And therefore, we have developed a telepresence robot called Fable Connect, which is affordable. So it's easier, it's simpler to get it into the classroom. And it's basically a small Skype on wheels. And this is something that is making a big difference for these kids. So this is an example project that we are very, very proud of. So this is a project together with the Danish Lung Association, where we are providing children in Denmark, all children in Denmark are giving the offer to actually get a telepresence robot if they have a lung disease. So lung disease children, they often cannot go to school for, you know, long, long periods of time. They're very prone to infections, and they're very, it can be very dangerous for them to get even a simple flu, or of course corona as well. So many of them have not been able to go to school for a long time. And this project here is helping many children come back to school. So what I want to do now is I want you to introduce you to this guy, Rasmus. So he's one of the children that has received the robot from the Lung Association. And before you start the video, Michael, I just want to apologize. It's in Danish, but I hope you get the meaning anyway.
Perfect. Just mute, then we will see it, David.
Hej, Charlotte. Jeg skal Ved du hvad? Ved du hvad, Rasmus? Jeg trykker lige sådan på, sådan, så du kun kan snurre rundt, sådan, så du ikke kan falde ud over bordet her, ikke? Sådan der, så du kører rundt. Har du haft en god weekend?
Du kan rigtig dreje rundt.
Det kan jeg. Har du haft en god weekend?
Ja, det har jeg. Ja. Har du haft?
Det har været dejligt vejr, ikke?
Ja, det har det. Det har været dejligt vejr i weekenden.
Og jeg kan se, at du er kommet hjem. Du er ikke i sommerhus mere.
Rasmus har været totalt isoleret i 14 måneder, da han på grund af en stærkt nedsat lungefunktion er ekstra udsat for coronasmitte. Han er stadig isoleret, og derfor er dette interview optaget via Teams.
Ved du, Rasmus, vi tager lige morgenrunden herinde i klassen, ikke også?
Yes.
Super. Han blev smidt hjem i marts måned. Ja, sidste år, ikke?
Ja.
Jeg blev ringet op af Rigshospitalet. Samme eftermiddag, som Mette Frederiksen lukkede resten ned,
ja.
Der ringede de og sagde, at nu skulle han i skærpet beskyttelse, og det var ikke noget offentlig transport, ikke noget skole, ikke noget svømning, ikke noget. Og jeg nåede lige at sige til min chef, inden jeg gik, at nu har de ringet og sagt sådan og sådan, og jeg ved jo ikke, hvor lang tid tager det. Kan være, der går 14 dage, før jeg kommer igen, eller, og nu er der gået 14 måneder.
Men kan du, Rasmus, eller du prøve at forklare, hvad det er, hvorfor I har glædet af en robot, eller hvorfor I har fået en robot overhovedet?
Ja, så siden vi har fået en robot, det er for, at jeg ligesom kan være med foran mine klassekammerater, og så kan jeg også lære nogle ting igennem, så jeg også nogenlunde lærer det samme, som børnene gør. Så lærer jeg det samme, så lærer det nogenlunde det samme, som de gør. Mm. Så dansk og matematik, så er jeg med til nogle af timerne, og nogle af de timer, jeg ikke kan være med til, så lukker de ned.
Ja.
Så er jeg faktisk bare med og kan kigge på mine klassekammerater, og spiller også med dem.
Det er rigtigt. Hvorfor spiller I?
Og især nu, når jeg har fået den der robot, hvor jeg ligesom selv kan styre, så kan den jo også gøre, så den kan række hånden op for mig. Det er meget smart.
Ja.
Så er det som om at være der i skolen. Det er det faktisk.
Det er da han fik den, så drønede han op og ned ad gangen, og han skulle ned og hilse på dem på kontoret. Så det var helt fantastisk. For hele skolen, faktisk.
Kender du et barn eller et ung menneske, der vil have glæde af en robot? Så læs mere på lunge.dk/robot.
Yeah, so actually, I just want to repeat the last message there. If you know anyone that needs one of these robots, has some kind of lung disease, then do reach out to Lungeforeningen, because they are actually providing these, and we are implementing them, you know, on a daily basis out there. So it's really making a lot of difference. We're approaching 300 Fable Connect robots out there. It was a new product for us that we put on the market in the autumn. And we're really seeing the schools being onboarded onto this very quickly. So 300 robots out there making a real difference for these kids. And it's amazing to see. I mean, it's being used a lot. Many, many kids are using them for 4, 6, 8 hours a day. They come spending time with their friends, being back in school. And you know, this really wouldn't happen if they didn't have one of our robots. So it's just fantastic to be able to help these kids for us. Yeah, so that was all that I wanted to say about the impact that we are doing at Shape Robotics, helping, you know, getting quality education and well-being to the students out there. So I hope that you have some questions, perhaps for me.
Yeah, just type your question on the right side, and I will ask them. Just type in Danish or in English. I will make sure to translate. But I would like to start with David. Are you seeing the budgets around the world being increased in this area? Are you seeing some, you know, a lot of people talk about Germany, for example, as really being a low on the technology side and on the education side. Are you seeing that societies are or that actually money is being put into projects? You know, we have a two-sided here. You clearly how you do impact is very clear, but on the business side, are you actually seeing money flowing into this area and thereby making new regulations to the school area that will put money into this area?
Absolutely. I mean, there's no doubt that a lot of projects was put on hold when Corona hit and all the schools closed down and they were focusing on other things. But we also see that a lot of projects are coming back and also that a lot of projects are being funded by the stimulus packages. So a lot of the stimulus packages are being funneled into education as well, making sure that, you know, all the you know, politicians, they know and they can see that they need to invest in these kinds of things if they want to stay ahead of the game, if they don't want to be outcompeted by Singapore or China, or, you know, what have you, then you need to do these kinds of things. Otherwise, you will just become outdated. And for example, in Germany, they have a big digital pact investment in the schools. In the US, we see a lot of the stimulus from the Biden administration going into the US schools. So really, it's a trend that we see a lot of money flowing into the Italy is another example where they also putting up big funds for the schools to apply for. So yes, we're seeing a reinvestment into the schools at the moment.
And there's a question here: which customer type is it? Private schools who are first movers, and then the public education coming in, and there's also ask what does one unit cost, and maybe you can distinguish between the Fable and the robot for educating schools and packages and so on, just to get an idea what the investment is, David.
Yeah, of course. So if I start with the last one there, so a telepresence robot is like the telepresence robot is 2400 for us, a small subscription. So it's very affordable, and you know what we see is that schools will typically buy 5-6 robots. That is kind of at the moment that is the trend. Municipalities will buy a slightly larger amount and then distribute it to the schools. Then we expect them to come back and buy more as they are implementing it. So it's a fairly small investment. Often we are starting now to sell it with the smartphone as well. And then on the education side, on the STEM, we normally will sell a class set of robots, so you know, enough robots for 25 students, for example, and that would be 30,000 to 40,000, depending on what you exactly want to buy. So that's the kind of investment that the schools are making. And then what was the first part of the question?
Sorry. Yeah, but is it more private or is it public? You know, you're talking about the stimuli, but are private schools a little bit ahead of the game and you're expecting that the public will return and try and catch up on that?
In some markets, yes. In some markets, they are ahead of the game, the private schools. In some markets, they're not. So in some markets, there is some, I mean, the thing is about the public sector is that when they do something, they will often, you know, do it big. So they are not, you know, sometimes, yes, they will still find a budget at a public school and then they will buy some Fable robots. But if a school districts in the US or in Russia, they do a big project with many, many labs, it, you know, that can be a really big project for our resellers. And they will provide, you know, equipment from many, many public schools, where the private school chains that tend to be slightly smaller, maybe more agile, maybe faster at making decisions, but maybe but maybe also, you know, in smaller volumes in the end. And of course, the motivation for doing it can be slightly different. Sometimes, I mean, everybody wants to provide a good education and everybody wants to, you know, be able to tell the parents, you know, this is great. And you know, see what we are teaching our kids and get the kids out there and you know, do a difference. But of course, in a private school, you know, the parents is the customer. So if they're requesting something, then you'll look at it more as a return of investment, where maybe in a public school, you know, it's a little bit different story.
So in the private sector, it might be a little bit faster sale, but in the public sector, you will probably get large sales, if I should kind of understand you.
Absolutely, you could generalize like that. Yeah.
Perfect. Thank you, David, for taking us through it. Clearly, an impact and a little bit of different than the green. So also interesting to understand those impact categories. But thank you, David, for taking us through the presentation.
You're very welcome. Thank you.